In order to find the force in each member of the truss, we can utilize our method of join by drawing the free body diagram of each one of them and identifying the loads in the member. So to start, our joint A has an external load of 130 pounds that is applied at an angle, whereas it is connected to a member AB and AC. In this case, on the free body diagram, I always go ahead and draw the forces in the tension direction. And if we get a negative number, that means that the member is in compression. So for our summation of forces along the vertical axis, we are getting an FAC value of negative 150 pounds. That means that the member is in compression. Whereas if we do summation of forces along the x direction, we are getting a value of FAB equals to 140 pounds. This means that the member is in tension. Now next, move to joint B. Here we have one of the member as zero force member, and we can prove it using the free body diagrams. Since two of the members are collinear and there is no external load or support at point B, so the third member that is not collinear is going to be a zero force member. By doing summation of forces along the y-axis, we can see that the force FPC is equals to zero, whereas summation of forces along the x-direction is giving the force in member BD as 140 pounds in tension. Next, we can move to joint C and repeat the same process of drawing the free body diagram and list it down all the unknown loads and the known loads as well. In this case, since the member CA was 150 pound in compression, that's why it is given as negative 150. Applying the equilibrium equation and simplifying, our FCD is coming as 150 pound in tension, whereas the value of FCE is coming as negative 180 pound. This negative sign is indicating that the member is in compression. Next, let's move to joint D. Here you can see that it is connected to four members. So whenever we are selecting the joint, we have to make sure that it has no more than two unknowns, because we only have two equilibrium equations to solve for these unknowns. Simplifying, we are getting the value of FDE as negative 120 pound, meaning that the member is in compression, whereas member DF is in tension, having 230 pounds. Finally, let's move to joint E and draw the free body diagram. Applying the equilibrium condition along the x direction, we get our final member load as negative 300 pound. Again, the negative sign is indicating that the member EF is in compression.